This is for HIP, hot isostatic pressing. It's kind of a complex setup, but essentially we would have power, right? Power supply. You would have temperature measurement and temperature control. And then quite often you have inert gas. Inert gas, because you want to, quite often when you do this, you are not talking about air sintering, certain inert gas. And the pressure line, you are applying pressure, you have to apply the pressure, pressure line, compressor. Okay? And then within the center, this is what we are talking about. Within the center, you have the pressure vessel. Okay? You have the pressurized gas, isostatic. You are using the gas to transfer the pressure, right? You are using the gas to transfer the pressure. Why not using liquid? Well, I guess for two reasons. One is liquid, the reactivity thing. What liquid are we going to use? Liquid metal? Of course, it's going to react a lot. Even liquid ceramics, there are not many liquid ceramics that are inert. You see what I mean? And also the thermal conduction through the liquid will be way higher than through the gas leak, thermal heat loss. So people are using gas. Of course, you need a heater. And let's say this cylindrical shape is your ceramic piece. You put that ceramic piece and you put a viscous coating, optional. Sometimes you put a glass coating around the ceramics. And then you put the gas around it to press it, okay? So essentially, this is the setup. You can imagine this is complex, right? This is complex. You use it only when it is absolutely necessary. Yeah, otherwise you don't go through such complication. Typically for ceramics that are sensitive to air and are difficult to sinter just by heat itself.